So I went to go see Stuber, the new comedy starring Kumail Nanjiani and Dave Bautista. The story of this Uber driver named Stu who ends up getting caught in a situation he did not want to get caught up in because of this police officer, this large, you know, very strong, aggressive, somewhat angry police officer played by Dave Bautista of WWE, and of course, he was Drax the Destroyer in the MCU. And although Stu is the, I guess, centerpiece main character, really it's Bautista, aka Vic's, story here as he tries to find and apprehend the criminal that killed his partner many years ago, and he ends up going for LASIK eye surgery at the beginning of the movie, but because the LASIK surgery did not fully, you know, when you get LASIK, it doesn't heal right away. It takes a little bit of few hours for your eyes to kind of get refocused again. He ends up getting a tip-off of where they might be able to find this criminal he's been looking for years and years and years. And he calls in an Uber. Well, really, his daughter calls in an Uber and takes the Uber driver on an adventure. Of course, the daughter called in the Uber for him to go visit her art show. It wasn't really to catch criminals, but because Vic is so determined to catch this guy, he turns the Uber driver into his partner. It's almost like a buddy cop movie, except one person is unwillingly the secondary cop. And like I said, the story really is about Vic, as he plays a character which we've seen a million times before, this cop who's way more focused on his career than he is on his family. And that becomes a story thread in the movie. You know, his daughter really wants to, you know, get his attention. She's been getting really big in the art scene. He, of course, just treats people really badly, very selfish to try to catch this guy, which I understand. You know, he's very motivated to try to catch this villain, but he's been paying more attention to his career than his home life, and that becomes a story. Now, Stu's biggest problem is a lot simpler than that. Stu has a crush on this girl who, every time she breaks up with a guy, and she always invites him over for sex. And the first time he took advantage of it, but this time he's kind of having second thoughts because he really has, you know, feelings for her. So this was a comedy, and I gotta tell you, the first half of this movie is really funny. Obviously, comedy is very subjective. The movie does have some really, really good laughs in the film, really because of Dave Bautista. The guy's so damn charismatic. If you liked how he was as Drax, especially in Guardians 2, this is a different kind of character, but at the same time, it's a very funny character. And there's some really good writing in this movie. Tripper Clancy wrote some very good jokes that reminded me of like the early days of The Simpsons. Lots of visual humor, lots of self-referential humor, a little bit of meta stuff in there as well. But again, it all depends on kind of your kind of comedy and what you're into. For me, though, this movie made me laugh several times. The first half is way better than the second half, though. The movie does tend to drag on a bit, and it's only 90 minutes. There's a scene in the film where Stu and Vic get into like a fight in a convenience store, which is like their version of Walmart, and it just goes on way too long, and it's just not very funny. They try to do the physical comedy slapstick stuff here, and it's just way over the top. Vic is just a regular human cop, but he's really big and strong, but he's still a human being, and he's ends up taking a pounding in this movie to where it's very unrealistic. It's not like it's Drax the Destroyer here, it's just a regular guy. And the whole story about the movie that makes it funny is that Vic is such like a masculine, you know, some would say it's toxic masculinity. Some would say that, you know, but that's part of the humor. You know, he's always, you know, angry, he's always irritated, doesn't care about anybody but himself, and of course he has his character arc. Meanwhile, Stu ends up learning self-respect, he ends up learning to value himself, and that's kind of his character arc. So the movie does have character arcs, but there's just way too many things here that are just kind of meh. One thing I will say that I liked is that the villain of the film, there's a couple of villains. I'm not going to spoil one of them, but the other one is actually one of the guys from the Raid movies. So that was pretty cool. Iko Uwais is the name of the actor, and he plays the villain who Vic is trying to go after that killed his partner, you know, so many years ago. He seems a bit wasted here, though. He doesn't really have much to do. It really is Batista's movie, and they even have some meta humor here. For example, they have a joke about Vic's ethnicity, and that's become a joke for years because in WWE there was a few years there where they would kind of tell people that Batista, when he was champion, his ethnicity would change depending on where WWE was touring. So the guy would like say he was Filipino one week and Greek, and I believe he's actually Filipino and Greek. I don't really remember what he actually is, but he could pass for a lot of different ethnicities and a lot of different races. But that being said, you know, it's interesting because his partner in the movie, who ends up getting killed, is played by Karen Gillan, who is the same lady who played Nebula in the MCU. And that's kind of interesting how you have, you know, it kind of reminds me of Men in Black International, you know, where you've got Thor and Valkyrie. Here you've got Drax and Nebula. And then that's, it's just weird when you see these actors together in other movies, but it's cool. Now, what did I think about the movie? It's okay. It's okay. From, I'd say it's about a 6 out of 10. Is it a movie you should go see in theaters? Probably not. You can probably wait for the Blu-ray or the Redbox. You know, it's my job, like I always tell you guys, to, you know, give you advice on whether or not you should go. And it is a fun movie. I had a good time seeing it. If you can catch it on a matinee, or if you have one of those AMC or Movie Pass gimmicks where you can just pay once a month and you're bored, it is worth seeing. First half is funnier than the second half. Batista's great, but it's just a cop comedy, and some of the jokes completely fall flat, especially when it comes to the character of Stu. You know, I like that actor, but the jokes, when he tells them, he doesn't really have that comedic timing that Batista has. He just doesn't have it. But of course, he's given less material to work with. But either way, some of the jokes don't work. Some of them do work. It's just, it's a run-of-the-mill detective comedy movie. That's pretty much what it is. It's a fun film. Didn't think it was a waste of time. But again, if you are tight on cash, you want to save up for something better, you know, for a date or for just your own enjoyment, there will be better comedies and better films coming out very shortly. Or there's already better stuff in the theater right now. Not that much better stuff, though, because this summer's kind of been meh. But if you haven't seen Spider-Man yet, you got to go see that. And there's other things you can go see. But overall, 6 out of 10 movie. That's my review of Stuber, and I hope you enjoyed it.